Okay, good morning. We're on to grade 7 mathematics, and we are on chapter 15 of our text, of our textbook, the new general mathematics for book 1, GSS 1. And then we started this topic. We have done simplification that has to do with multiplication. And I guess you would have gained one or two things from multiplying letters, multiplying numbers and letters, and multiplying numbers with same letters. I think those are the three things this chapter actually focused on. Today we're going to, how do we handle division as it regards how does it, as it borders around dividing the letters, dividing numbers, and where should we use such things? So we'll go straight away to the board and see how things would play out. Okay, so exercise. And 15B will focus on division of tens. That's what we'll focus on. Division of tens is what we're going to focus on now. Okay. All right, I guess it's better now. Okay, so we'll go to exercise 15B. Let's see how that is done. The first one says 6A over 3. Now, when you're dividing terms, because we're just starting, I'll try to make it as simple as possible. 6A will mean 6 times A divided by 3. So we would cancel the numbers. Numbers can be cancelled. Numbers can be cancelled, right? So this will give me 2, and that will be 2e. 2 times e becomes what? 2e. I see that. Question 2. In question 2, we are told 12e divided by 2. Now, what does that mean? This will mean 12e over 2. Now, please, you need to understand this very well as we begin to do this. I guess that by now, nobody has an issue with what this is interpreted as, because we have cleared these in previous classes. So this will be equal to what? 12 times a divided by 2, and that will be 6. So the answer becomes 6a. I'm only doing it because we are at the introductory level. As we begin to progress deeper, I wouldn't do that. Now, number 3, 1 over 4 of 24x. What's the interpretation of this? This is 1 over 4 times 24 what? X, which is also interpreted as 24 times x over 4. So this will cancel here 1, this will go here 6. Now to understand this, take note that we expect that at this level you should be able to use your rules of divisibility. That will be one of the topics in grade 8 I'm going to take very soon. I would have to take that so that will improve your ability to divide. Now, question 4. In question 4, what do you have? Question 4, you have 18y divided by 6. 18y divided by 6. So that would mean what? 18y divided by 6. So this time around, I wouldn't multiply out again because I expect that you should have an idea of what's happening now. So I will cancel. This go here, 1. 6 can divide. 6 go here, 3. And that will be what? 3y. Now, the question will be, why are you not taking the division gradually? Yes, sometimes I discover that when you make the thing too systemic, this is how you do it. So students get so used to it. And when the idea or what you need to use would change, they can't even see it. So here, 6 can divide that. So I'm going to be using big numbers to divide to open your thinking. Now, number 5, settle down. Number 5, 1 over 5 of 50x. And that would be equal to 1 over 5 times, of means times. Of means what? Times 50x. So next thing you cancel at 15 here 1, 15 here 3, and that will give you 3x. I was seeing that. Now number 6. You have 32c over 8. They are both even numbers. So what can divide? 2 can divide. 4 can also divide. So instead of using 2 to divide, I'll divide straight with what? 4. 4 here 2, 4 here 8, 2 here 1, 2 here 4. And that will give me 4c. So the answer to that question is 4c. All right. Now let's go to question 7. I trust you have solved this already, so it's no longer new. 1 over 8 of 32x. So what does that mean? That will mean 32x over 8. And this go here, 2. This go here will give me 8. 2 go here, 1. 2 go here, 4. And that will give me 4x. All right. So question 8. 21y over 3. What does that give you? That will give you, you can actually from this point cancel straight. 3 go here 1, 3 go here 7. And that will give me 7y. All right. So maybe I'll also go back to make it more simplistic. Number nine says 1 over 7 times 35y. 7 go here 1, 7 go here 5, and that will give me 5y. Number 10, we have 1 over 9 times x. Now, the narrative is changing here a little now. If you discover, for this is 1 over 9, and for every whole number written, it's always over 1. Or every whole number or letter written is always over 1. So this is a numerator over 1. The reason why x is x is because x is standing on the denominator 1. So this will now give me what? X over 9. X over 9. That'll give me x over 9. Okay, so that's for question 10. Right, so we'll just pause a while and so let's go to question 11. In question 11, we are told 1 over 4 of D. This would be 1 over 4 times D over 1. And that will be D over 4. What's happening? When you multiply, denominators will multiply denominators, and denominators to denominators, numerator to numerator. Question 12. X times 1 over 2. This will give me X over 1 times 1 over 2, which will give me X over 2. All right, for question 13. 28ab divided by 4. Now, what would this be? This would be 28ab over. Divided means over 4. So what can happen here? 4 can go here 1. 4 can go into here 7. Notice that the 4 is a number and we only divide the number. Come again. 4 is a number, and we only divide the number. So that will give me what? 7AB. Now in question 14, we have that 60XY divided by X. This one is equal to 60XY over X. Now, be careful here. The denominator is a letter. What type of letter? X. Is there a numerator? X. Is there a letter in the numerator? X. Yes. So that is what it will cancel. Now, so that will give me what? 60Y. Now, if that is too difficult for you to see, let's now go this way. So this becomes clearer, and that will give me what? 16Y, right? So you either use this one or this one. Now, question 15. 30PQ divided by 6. Step 1, divided is over. So 30PQ over 6. What is 6? 6 is a number. What can it cancel? Another number also. 6 will go here 1, 6 will go here 5. And that will give me 5PQ. How we are seeing it, it's a step-by-step thing. What's most important in this aspect of mathematics is your thinking, your thought process. So please try to ensure you're following how we are handling this. In question 16, 17mn divided by n. So what does this give you to be 17mn over n? 17mn over n. So what do you do at this level? What is the denominator? The denominator is n. What can n cancel? N will cancel its corresponding neighbor in the numerator part. So this n will go with this n. And this will give me 17m. So this will now give you 17m. Now for question 17, this will be 22kl divided by 11. Here again, it will be 22kl over 11. What is 11? 11 is a number and it's a factor of 22. So 11 go here 1, 11 go here will give me 2. So this will give me 2KL. Number 18. In question 18, we have 6AB divided by B. That will give me 6AB over B. Is that not? What is B? B is a letter. What can it cancel? A letter like itself. B will go with B, and that will give me 60. I hope you're getting this. Good. Now, question 20. Question 19, rather. We have D squared divided by D. Here, I have to pause. How many D's do you have here? Remember, we said that the index, you see, now notice that with the concepts, you've already seen this before, but now we want to use it now in practice. D squared means that D is multiplied 2 times. So step 1, this will be D squared over D. That's the first thing. Take care of this division sign. It means this over this. Next thing, how many D's do you have? This is 2. D times D over D. I see that D will cancel D, and the final answer becomes what? D. I see that. Question 20. A divided by A squared. What is the interpretation of this? It is A over A squared. How many A's do you have in the denominator? 2. Notice that now the A in the denominator is 2 multiplied twice as against the numerator. So this will be A over A times A. So what's the next thing? They are both letters. What letter can cancel out? It's A. So this will cancel this. And what would you be left with? You'll be left with what? So from this, you'll be left with, let me put the answer here. You'll be left with 1. 1 is what is left here. This cancel is get 1. 1 over the A that is left in the denominator. So, all right, so we're done with that. We're done with that one. Take another short break to allow that sink, and then we'll continue. Okay, question 21. Z squared over Z. So that one is equal to Z times Z. Z is multiplied twice over Z. So this will cancel this, and your final answer becomes what? Z. In 22, now you have 3x squared divided by x. 3x squared divided by x. Okay, so that said, you would have that this will be equal to what? 3 times x over x. So this x will go with this x, and you'll be left with 3 times x, which is what? 3x. Now, 23. Now, I'm going to stretch you a little. Let me see if I have a question like that. Now, look at this 6x squared divided by x. I think that's what question 23 wants, right? So this will give me 6x squared over x. Now, I will stretch your thinking a little. If you cancel this x, it will cancel one here. Don't worry, if you don't catch it so well now, I won't use it all the time, but I just want you to start getting used to some kind of thinking. It's not too early for you to start getting used to some thinking. If I cancel one of the x here, remember that we said that this x means x is multiplied twice. It means that I've reduced the index by one. So if I cancel, maybe I should go to a bigger space so that the idea will be well passed. Now look at that. 6x squared divided by x. What would this be? 6x squared divided by x. If I cancel this, I would have affected the index here by one. So this will now give me what? 6x as my final answer. Or maybe we'll use the other method you are used to too. That would be 6x squared over x, which would be 6 times x over x. So it's called I still was 6x. So you can use this one and use this one and try to see whether you have done it correctly. All right, that's for question 23. So what about 24? In question 24, we have that 5c squared over c. What would that be? That would be what? C here, 1. C here, 1. So that would be what? 5c. Try to get used to it so that when you go to higher classes, it becomes like a walkover for you. Now, let's look at question 25. In 25, what do you have? 3x cubed over x. 3x cubed over x. Remember that this x means that x is multiplied 3 times. So if I cancel one here, I would have affected this 3 to be reduced to what? 2. So this will become what? 3x to the power of what? 2. Just try to follow me, huh? 26. You have 2x cubed over x. So what would that give you? If I cancel this one, I would have affected this by what? 1. That would be 2. So that would be 2x squared. 27. This would be 5x cubed over what? X squared. Now take note that this one means x is multiplied 2 times, x is multiplied 3 times. So this one, I'll use both methods to show you what has happened there. Times x, times x, times x. Over x times x. So what is happening here? You can cancel this and this. You cancel this and this. I seen that. So your final answer becomes 5x. But that's what you were taught at your level. But let's take you to where we'll be staying in our new grid. X is multiplied how many times? 2 times. X is multiplied how many times? 3 times. So I'll cancel all of this. And I'll cancel this one. How many will I remove from here? It is 2. So this will not be left. I'll be left with 1. So this becomes what? 5x. All right. So that settles that one. All right. So we'll continue. So let's continue, eh? Let's continue. We'll try to do our best, eh? Okay, so what number? I was on number 20. I've done 27. I think it was 27 I did last, or 26. So I'm going to 28. Am I correct? I should be doing 28 now. Please confirm to me. So that's 12x to the power of 3 to the power of 2 over 3x. Now, in this one, there are 2 things involved here now. Let me use method 1. Here, I'm going to be a little slow. I will not go beyond this today. Now, this will be what? 12 times x squared over 3 times x. I see that this 3 will cancel this 1, this 3 will cancel this 4. Are you with me? This x will cancel here 1. It will cancel the index 1. So that will be equal to what? 4x. Remember, I'm not just playing with what you have done already in school. I'm taking you a step higher than what you have done in school. Huh? So I will trust you adjust to this method. So that's that for this one. And let's go to 29. In 29, it is what? 18a cubed over what? 3a. So to make it easy, because we are just starting, I will say 18 times a cubed divided by 3 times what? A. The 3 will cancel this, and the 3 will cancel 18, and you get what? 6. A will cancel A1, but it will not cancel this A. It will deal with the index. 3 minus 1, A I've taken away, and that will be what? 2. So that will give me what? 6A to the power of what? 2. Are we together? Please, let's all try to settle down. Question 30. In question 30, we have 26x squared divided by x, divided by 2x, sorry. So what would this give me? This will give me 26 times x squared. I'm doing this just to make it easy for you to perceive what we are doing. 26 times x squared divided by 2 times x. So these 2 will cancel here, 1. 2 into 16 will give me 13. Are we together? Then the x will go here, 1. The x will go here, 1. Remember that the x canceling the numerator does not take care of the x, but it takes care of the index. Thank you. So this will give me what? 30x. All right. That's for question 30. What happens in question 31? In question 31, we have that. Now, this is one I may want to spend some time to explain. Now, look at that carefully. Can the numbers cancel out? No. Numbers cancel out as a function of their HCF. Numbers will cancel out as a function of their HCF. 33 and 8 have no common factor except 1. So and it makes no difference to do that. If you look at the numerator and the denominator, m is not the same thing as a, neither is n the same thing as a. So nothing can happen there. And so your final answer will be what? 33 m over a. Is that clear? All right. Now the next one, question 32. In question 32, we have 42xy divided by 7y. So how do you handle this? Quite simple again. You would have 42. Okay, this one is straight. You can cancel straight away. It will not be a problem. 7 go here 1, 7 go here 6. Y is also in the numerator. Cancel and cancel because this is not to any index, or rather, any index other than 1. So you can easily cancel that. And the answer becomes what? 6x. 33. What is 33 talking about? In question 33, you have 54ab over 9b. So what is that? This will be equal to what? 9 go here 1, 9 go here 6, b go here 1, b go here 1, and that will be what? 6a. I also advise you at the end of this exercise to take the exercise again. Cover your notebook, try to solve everything, and see whether you still get the same answers using the same method you have, using the new methods you have learned today. If there's a challenge, please send me a chat. If there's a challenge, just send me a chat. All right. So, question 34. We have 72a squared b over 8a. All right. Now, look at this. The numbers can cancel out. And if 8 go here, I'm going to get 1. 8 go here, I'm going to get 9. And then A go here 1. A will deal with the index, and that'll be what? 1. So that'll be equal to what? AB. That'll be equal to what? AB. All right, that's for 34. What about 35? What about 35? In question 35, you have, okay, let's go to a new page for question 35, because 35 might be, I want to take a lot of space. So let's go to a new page for 35. Now, 35. In 35, you have 48x squared y over 12xy. Now, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to split this one because I want you to understand what's happening here. 48 times x squared times y all over 12 times x times, sorry, times y. Now, these two can cancel themselves. They are both even numbers. So 4 can go, 3, 4 here, 12. 3 can go, 3 here, 1, 3 here, 4. So in writing my answer, I'll put 4 first. I'll go to x. X will cancel here 1. X will cancel the index 1. So I'll be left with x. Y and y can cancel themselves out. So my final answer becomes what? 4x. Question 36. In question 36, you have 40bq squared over 8pq. So what would this be? This would be 40 times p times q squared over 8 times p times q. Observe that 8 can cancel 40, and that will be 5. P will cancel P. Q go here 1. And then Q will go here 1. So that will give me what? 5 what? Q. That will give me 5Q. And with that, we are done with the exercise. Break that. Now for question 34, we forgot to complete this. Maybe it would be wise to resolve 34. 34 is 7 7a squared b, 72a squared b over 8a. I hope that's what the question says. Right, so let's correct that. You're right, I think there's an issue with that. Now, this will give me what? 72 times a squared times b over 8a. All right, now 8 will go here 1, 8 will go here 9. Yes, I forgot to write the 9. If that's where the issue is, then a go here 1, we deal with the index, and that'll be a, and that's times b. So that'll be 9ab. Does that solve the issue? All right, I see the change in the expression of your face. All right, okay, that's good.